Hello! In this video, we're going to look at one of the easiest ways to broadcast live and to multi-stream. That's, say, broadcast to Facebook, YouTube, LinkedIn, all at the same time. It's StreamYard. Let's do it! Hello, my name's Ian Anderson Gray from the Confident Live Marketing Academy. So do you want to broadcast live to Facebook, YouTube, LinkedIn, Twitch, and more really easily? Want to see comments in your live broadcasts from all those places and to highlight them on the screen? Want to add titles, graphics, and videos to your screen and invite up to 9 guests onto your broadcast? Well, StreamYard is one of the easiest live video streaming tools out there, and in this video, I'll show you how to get started. Over the last year, I've talked a lot about a similar service, Restream, but I've always had a lot of love for StreamYard. StreamYard was launched back in 2018 by Gage Vandentrop and Dan Briggs, and I had the pleasure of meeting Gage back in 2020 at Social Media Marketing World. The team are really fantastic people. StreamYard is a web-based tool, and so it works in your browser for both PC and Mac users, so you don't need to download anything. Although you could say it's not as powerful or feature-rich as some other tools, downloadable apps like vMix, Wirecast, or Ecamm Live, it offers that perfect sweet spot between ease of use and power. And the way you can easily multi-stream to Facebook Live, YouTube Live, and more all at the same time is amazing. So let's open up StreamYard now. At the time of recording, there are 4 different plans. Obviously, this will vary, the prices will vary depending on when you're watching this. But at the moment, there is a free plan, which is a great way to test out StreamYard. They do put on the StreamYard watermark on the screen, and you have a limitation in terms of how many minutes or how many hours you can broadcast to. You can have up to 5 guests on your broadcast as well, but you do have features like green screen and the ability to broadcast to Facebook Live, LinkedIn Live, and all those other channels. The basic plan removes those watermarks, so you can add your own branding. You can have up to 9 guests on your shows. You can get all fancy and broadcast to a custom place using RTMP, and you can multi-stream. So that's going live to more than one place at the same time, up to 3 on the basic plan. The professional plan allows you to broadcast to up to 8 places at the same time. You can do high definition, that's 1080p, that's full HD. It will also record not just the video, but also the audio in separate channels. And finally, they've also got business plans. So if you're part of a larger team, you might want to check out the business plan. One of the things I love about StreamYard is the clean interface. There's no clutter and it's just really easy to use. On the left-hand menu, we've got broadcasts. This allows us to set up a new broadcast and also to see previous broadcasts. The video library contains all the recordings from your previous broadcasts, whether they are live broadcasts or whether you're just recording them for later. The destinations part allows you to add your Facebook channel, LinkedIn channel, and more, so you can broadcast live to them. At the moment, you can add destinations such as your Facebook page, group, and profile, your LinkedIn page or profile, your YouTube channel, Twitter, Twitch, Hopin, and custom RTMP, which basically means you can add pretty much any other channel out there. The member section allows you to add your team members. You get 1 free team member with the paid plans at the moment. And of course, if you've got a business plan, you can add more. So let's create a broadcast. Let's go to broadcasts, click on create a broadcast, and you have 2 options. Most people are going to create a new broadcast, but if you do have a pre-recorded video that you want to broadcast live, you do have the ability to upload that video and then broadcast that as if it were live. Now, of course, Facebook and YouTube have premiere services, so you could use that or you could use this. It's up to you. But let's create a new broadcast. Now it's asking you to choose which destinations you want to broadcast live to. If you're just wanting to record, you can just click on record only. Otherwise, if you want to broadcast to 1 or more, you just select them here. I'm going to select Twitter and YouTube. Just enter the title of your broadcast in here. Now you can go live straight away, or in most cases, you'll want to schedule this for later. When you schedule for later, you get a few more options. You can upload a thumbnail image, and I highly recommend that you do that. They say the recommended size is 1280x720. I actually recommend 1920x1080. Here's one I prepared earlier. Now it's time to select the date and time for your live broadcast. Now you need to click on the button Customize for each destination. So if you want, you can just click on Create Broadcast, but what I recommend is going into each destination and change a few of the settings. So for my Facebook group, I could change the description a little bit. And one thing to remember about Facebook groups is that when people leave a comment on the Your Live video in a Facebook group, unless they've given permission for StreamYard to see their name and their photo, you won't be able to see it. So they need to click on a special link that StreamYard will give you. And so if you want to add those instructions to the post, you just need to check that button. You can also have a different image for each destination that you broadcast to. I'm going to keep it the same for all. Twitter, there aren't really any settings for Twitter, but what I will do is I will mention StreamYard in here. So I'm going to actually @mention them there. For YouTube, you do have a few extra settings. You can change the privacy. So in this case, I'm going to change this to an unlisted video. Let's create the broadcast. So there we go. It's all been set up here. I can click on those three dots. I can view the post on Facebook. And I can view the scheduled post on YouTube. You can see it's going live in 2 days. Let's enter the studio. So I don't need to go into the studio until 10, 15 minutes before I'm actually going to go live, but let's just have a look at it now. So I can mute and I can stop my camera. And when you first do this, you'll be asked to select which camera and which microphone you're going to use. Let's click on camera and mic. So here you can select which camera you want, and you've also got some advanced options. If you're on the professional plan, you'll have the option for high definition if your camera supports it. And I'm gonna have 1080p there as my camera resolution. Under audio, you can also choose which microphone you want. And the speaker, where do you want the sound to go? If you're not wearing headphones, I would recommend wearing headphones. If you're not wearing headphones, you can check echo cancellation and that will try and get rid of any echo on the system. You've got the option for stereo audio and also you can get it to automatically adjust the mic volume. What's really cool here is the virtual background. Ideally, you'd have a green screen, but StreamYard can also work without a green screen. So I can blur my background. I can put a brick wall behind me. Or I can be in a beautiful lounge area with a grand piano, or I can be outside a restaurant. You can upload your own backgrounds as well, which is cool. And of course, if you have a green screen, you can check the green screen button and it's a lot better. And if you're interested to find out a little bit more about how you can use green screens in StreamYard, you just need to click on the video up there somewhere. If you're feeling fancy and advanced, you can also set up hotkeys to do some advanced things like changing the layout or muting your audio and things like that. And if you're feeling even more fancy, you can connect your Stream Deck to your computer and set up all the hotkeys for that. I'm not going to go through that now because that's a bit more advanced. You can see if your audio is going through just with this nice little meter here. And of course, you want to enter your name. It's already entered for me there. Let's click on Enter Studio. So at the moment, I've got a background image and I've got a logo on the top right. You can't see me. I haven't added anything onto the screen yet. I'm going to go through that in a minute. When you're live and you have some comments, you'll see the comments turn up here on the right. Here's a test comment here, which I can highlight on the screen. Let's go to banners. These are some example banners. This allows you to put titles on the screen to make it more valuable and to give some really helpful information as you go through your video. You could split them up into different folders, which I have already. And if you're wanting to change the look and feel of these, you can just by going over to the brand part. So you can change the color of these. You can put the hex code in there, or you can go to there and just change the color. Let's say if we wanted a green, change it to a green and it will change it like that. I prefer this color though. Let's do this. You've got different themes. So we can have bubble, classic, minimal, or block. You don't have the same amount of customization as other tools like Ecamm Live or vMix or OBS, but for most people, these are absolutely fine. Now we can set the logo on the top right of the screen. So we could have the StreamYard one or my Confident Live Marketing Podcast one. Now with a logo, you're best keeping it square and about 200 pixels by 200 pixels. At the time of recording, you haven't got the ability to move it anywhere else on the screen, but in most cases, most people put the logo on the top right of the screen anyway, so it's no big deal. You can add overlays on the screen as well, which you can upload for later. So these are ones that I've created before. These are images that are placed on top of your videos. And you can add some video clips. Here's a countdown that's already baked into StreamYard. And here's one that I did for my church. And then we've got background. So at the moment, we've got the curtain background, but I could change the background for something else. So far, I haven't added myself onto the screen, which is very rude. So let's do that now. At the bottom, this is kind of like the green room. So I'm currently in the green room, and if I had any guests, they would also be in the green room as well. So let's just click on the add to stream to add me in. And there you go, I'm on the screen there at the moment. Now I'm not full screen at the moment, and that's because of a setting that I discovered the other day in settings. If I click on settings and go down to layouts, there's an option to crop solo layout to show the background image, which is quite nice. If it's just me on the screen, I might want to see the background image. But if I uncheck that, I'll now be full screen there. Because I don't have any remote guests at the moment, or I haven't shared my screen, none of these layouts are really going to do anything because there's just me on the screen. So let's do a bit of fancy stuff. I'm going to click on share. And I've got different options here. I can add slides. I can add a video file from locally from my computer, or I can share my screen. Let's share my screen. Got the option for it sharing your entire screen. I can do a window on my computer, or if you're running a Chrome browser, you can do Chrome tab. The advantage with Chrome tab is that you can also share the audio of this. So if you're like playing a YouTube video or want to play some sounds, the audio will come through as well. But I'm gonna just share this window here, the StreamYard pricing window, and click on share. So I can see that this is now sharing. Let's go back to StreamYard and I can see that's on the screen there. So I've got different layouts here. So currently this is the screen layout. I can go to picture in picture layout like that, or I can just get rid of me as well. I can also go like that, so my screen is on the right. There are different hotkeys here, so Shift and 5 is that, Shift and 6, Shift and 7, and Shift and 8, which is really handy as I go through. If I want to go to solo layer, I just go back to there. Hello, it's Future Ian here. Now, just as I was about to publish this video, StreamYard came up with a new cool feature, which I have to share with you. It's the ability to add an extra camera. So you now have the ability to add multiple cameras as a host or a co-host. At the time of recording, this is one extra camera, although they might have the ability to add more than one extra camera in the future. To do this, you click on share at the bottom, and you've got this new button here that says extra camera. Select the second camera from the list here and click share. The extra camera will appear in your green room, and to add it to the stream, you just click on the add to stream button. So there you go. I'm sharing multiple cameras on my broadcast. This is only available to hosts and co-hosts. Guests don't have this ability at this present time. This could be particularly useful if you have a downwards facing camera and you want to share a new product that you're reviewing or something like that. For example, for Amazon Live. Back to old Ian. Let's invite a guest. So when you invite a guest, you can do this before you go live. You can set this up as soon as you've scheduled the broadcast. You can do this, but I'm just gonna invite myself onto the broadcast. So I'm gonna copy that link. And this is what happens when the guest clicks on the link. They need to allow the mic and cam access, click on allow, and then they just need to choose the camera. I'm gonna mute myself. I'm gonna call myself Pete. Click on enter studio. So when they enter, they will be in the green room, but they will be able to see the broadcast. Let's go back to the host. So you can see at the bottom, Pete has been added to the green room at the bottom there. I can add him to the broadcast. So we've got the different options for layout here. We've got the cropped layout, which is like that. You can also do the group layout, spotlight layout, and you can have a lot of fun with all these different layouts here. Once you want to remove your guest, you can just click on remove like that. And of course, if you want to have solo layouts, you can just click on the solo layout button at the top left of each thumbnail. Of course, they look the same because it's me. When it's time to go live, you need to obviously click the go live button there on the top. So let's go live now. And I'm live. So this is just a test to see if it's working. I'm currently doing a tutorial on how to use StreamYard. So if you're watching, hello. But this is how you do it. So I can see on the top left-hand side, I can see I've been going live for 16 seconds. And I can see the number of live viewers. At the moment, I've got none. But also you can see at the moment, oh, I've actually got one person watching live on YouTube, which is probably me actually. And I can see there are no people watching on Facebook. Oh, you don't have the ability to see on Twitter how many live viewers there are, but that's just one of the problems with Twitter at the moment. It's the Twitter API doesn't really give you much information. Oh, actually, just before I do that, I can see we've got somebody watching on Facebook. So I can see that comment there. It says Facebook user, and that's because the person who's leaving this comment, they need to click on the link to give Facebook permission for me to see their name. and picture. But it's great that they can see me and hear me on Facebook. So thank you, person. Thank you, Facebook user. But it's time to end the broadcast. Let's click on end broadcast. So see you soon. And there we go. That's the end of the broadcast. A few other features. You've got private chat. This allows you to chat privately with your guests, which is really, really useful. So those are the main features about StreamYard. There are loads of other things which I will be talking about in future videos. So what do you think about StreamYard? What are your favorite features? I'd love to know what you think. Let me know in the comments below. And if you want to take StreamYard for a test drive, just head on over to iag.me/StreamYard. Don't forget to subscribe to this channel and like this video. I will be doing loads more videos on StreamYard and other live video tools, so you won't want to miss out on those things. But until next time, toodaloo.